Gildan Media presents Your Coach in a Box, affordable, life-changing audio programs.
Charlie, A Monkey Ate My Pancakes. Written by Raj Gill, as read by Raj Gill. It was a bright and sunny Saturday morning. The sun beaming into Charlie's bedroom was all he needed to wake up fully energized. Charlie launched himself out of bed and ran into the bathroom.
"This is Alpha Bravo Charlie 007. Come in, base command," Charlie said.
He often used his toothbrush as a pretend walkie-talkie. "I will now commence Operation Freshen Up. Brush, brush, brush. Floss, floss, floss. Swish, swish, swish. Gargle, gargle, gargle. Spit." And Charlie was done. "Over and out." Charlie nodded sternly to his reflection in the bathroom mirror. Then, with a quick spin, marched back to his room. Charlie heard a strange sound coming from the closet.
"Ee-ee-ee."
"Ah!" Charlie screamed, sprinting out of his bedroom and into the hall. He paused for a moment, trying to calm down, and then quietly crawled back to his room, picking up his toy water soaker on the way. He pointed the water soaker at the door and shouted,
"Come out with your hands up! I have a super-duper sonic blaster and I'm not afraid to use it!"
Charlie paused, expecting a response, but no sound came from the closet and the door stayed shut. After another few seconds of waiting, Charlie threw open the closet door. From behind all of the clothes, there jumped out a monkey.
"Ee-ee-oo-oo-ah-ah, ee-ee-oo-oo-ah-ah,"
it screamed, leaping onto Charlie's bed.
"Mommy, there's a monkey in my room. Come quick," Charlie shouted downstairs.
Charlie's dad knew that his son had quite the vivid imagination, so he sternly responded,
"Charlie, that's enough."
"But Dad,"
cried Charlie.
"No buts.
Now hurry on down for breakfast. We're having pancakes," called Charlie's mom from the kitchen.
Charlie loved pancakes, but he knew he had to check just one last time for the monkey before he went downstairs. But when he poked his head through the doorway, the monkey was gone. He looked up, down, and all around. No more monkey. Where could he have gone? Charlie asked himself. He then noticed that his bedroom window was open, the drapes blowing in the wind. Charlie guessed the monkey must have gone outside. He stuck his head outside, but still didn't see anything. "Huh," Charlie wondered, "where on earth could that monkey have gone?" Charlie gave up his search when he suddenly smelled the sweet pancakes from down below. He ran downstairs and took his seat at the table.
"Good morning, Dad,"
Charlie said cheerfully, his eyes wide with excitement. If you haven't figured it out yet, Charlie loved pancakes.
"Morning, buddy,"
Charlie's dad replied, his face covered by the newspaper.
A plate stacked high with pancakes sat on the table.
"Yummy," said Charlie, licking his lips. He poured a glass of milk and picked up his fork and knife, ready to dig in.
Suddenly, the monkey from Charlie's bedroom leapt out from underneath the table, swiped his pancakes, knocked over the glass of milk and maple syrup, and took off out of the kitchen, pancakes in hand. "Dad, did you see that?"
Charlie shouted.
"That monkey stole my pancakes."
Charlie's dad didn't even look up from his newspaper. He just said,
"Come on, Charlie, cut it out."
Charlie's mom, thinking he was just making up another silly story, rolled her eyes when she saw her son's empty plate.
"You're gonna get a tummy ache if you eat that fast. Now clean up your plate."
"But Mom," cried Charlie.
"No buts," replied Charlie's dad firmly.
Charlie cleaned up and ran upstairs to look for the monkey. He was angry at the monkey for stealing his breakfast, especially a pancake breakfast. He stopped in his tracks when he felt something sticky under his foot. There was a trail of maple syrup that led straight to the closet. This time, Charlie was confident. He threw open the closet door.
The monkey was sitting on the floor, scarfing down the last of his pancakes.
How are you enjoying my pancakes, Mr. Monkey?
Yummy, replied the monkey, rubbing his belly with his sticky maple syrupy hands.
The monkey then grabbed Charlie's baseball jersey and cap and went flying out of the window, throwing on the stolen clothes as he ran.
Hey, Mr. Monkey.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.